While reading something for a school assignment, a novel, or a technical summary of a country's current economic situation, you may suddenly realize that you're only reading the words, but not really absorbing anything. In other words, you aren't comprehending the content right in front of your eyes. Despite a good amount of research on this phenomenon, we don't really know why we sometimes end up reading on autopilot, though there are some theories to explore. The keep reading but the mind wanders off effect is widespread, or at least more common than you might think. When you read something, your brain connects and engages the contents of your memory in a new or less frequently used way. In neuroscience, the Hebbock theory suggests an explanation for the adaptations of neurons in the brain when learning, basically saying that the connection between two neurons can be strengthened if the neurons fire at the same time. For this to happen, you must focus on the subject you are reading about. You should do something with what you're reading, such as visualizing the scene in your head or creating a mental summary. These are the same processes associated with working memory and can help in the formation of stronger connections. When you think about something other than reading, your working memory becomes occupied with other thoughts, such as daydreaming. As a result, you can't make connections within your knowledge base because you're thinking about something else. You may read a full page, but your brain can't process what you consume in a meaningful way. Think of your attention like a spotlight on a stage that centers your attention. Usually, you only focus on what is in the spotlight, even though plenty is going on outside the light. However, that doesn't mean you have completely blocked out everything else that's happening. Similarly, if you read but aren't fully occupied by the book, you won't fully understand what you just read, as the spotlight is focused on something else. The brain is constantly bombarded with information from the outside world. Fortunately, the human attentional system of the brain ensures that you only pay attention to the things you really need to consider. According to Daniel J. Levitin, a scientist and the author of The Organized Mind, the human attentional system is divided into four parts: central executive mode, mind-wandering mode, attentional filter, and attentional switch. The more time you spend reading, the longer it exists as a part of your environment. Consequently, your attentional filter gradually blocks out the book. This means that your focus will need to be maintained entirely by the central executive mind, which takes a significant amount of effort. Your brain is designed to minimize effort, so it may assign the tiring task of reading to the mind-wandering mode to increase efficiency. The advantage of this is that you can still read with minimal effort, while simultaneously thinking about something that is completely unrelated. The downside, however, is that our mind-wandering mode is not particularly good at processing information that is structured or intentional. As a result, a person will end up reading on autopilot without really interpreting most of the text, and will inevitably have to start over at the top of the page.